Build Show Network, what's up guys? I got the boys with me today, and if you saw my previous video, Will is doing a great job of being a little mini Matt entrepreneur. Will, tell us what you earned today.
I made 20 bucks for taking out people's trash on trash day and returning it back to the side of their house.
Isn't that awesome? I didn't do that. I threw a lot of papers as a kid. I did a lot of lawn mowing, but Will's taken to using his Champion power washer and power washing, taking out people's trash. It pays for his fishing habit with his brother John here. And Matthew is actually named after me, but I wanted to give you a little update on today's video on our real rebuild. And here's a little secret that I have not told anybody before. My real rebuild, which is this house under construction here, is directly across the street from my current house. never said that on camera before. So it's been incredible having the boys watch me build. All right, guys, I'm gonna go across the street. I'll see y'all a little later.
Bye.
Let's do a little update here on what's happening at the real rebuild job. I've been a little bit slow on this. You know, the client is me. I don't have a paying client. So I haven't been in any big rush to finish this job and get out of here. I think the last time you guys saw it, we were talking about the rain screen detail and the exterior foam. We're just finishing up on window install today, and then we're gonna be getting into trades here pretty soon. The next thing that's gonna start is the plumbing and the HVAC trades. I just made a video earlier today that you'll see on my YouTube channel, which is gonna be about these windows. These are actually Jeldwin's sightline windows. And these are triple glaze, all these additional windows that I have for my house. If you follow the story on this real rebuild, I initially thought I was just remodeling the house. I was doing a really efficient house, but I wasn't going for any special certification. And then as I got into it and realized, you know, I should just demo this down to the slab and start fresh. When I had that option, I said, you know, maybe I should actually rate this to passive house standards. I've not built a passive house before. I've built a lot of efficient. When I did that, I started looking into my glazings and realized, you know, I probably need to look at my overall heat loss and gain and consider going to some triple glaze. And so that's what I did. I varied. Some of my house has double glaze, some has triple. Now, when you go to triple glaze with Jeldwin, Sightline is their more premium brand. This is a wood window. Look how nicely these are packaged. Real wood packaging around the outside. And this is a real wood window. This white thing you're seeing right here, that's just some packaging to help keep these safe in transit. And what you're seeing down here now is this is the true wood window. This is the actual black wood painted on the inside. And then I've got another window unpacked over here I can show you. They're a wood window that's been clad in aluminum. So this is that sightline window. The other cool thing about this is they include a head flashing with the window that's loose right here. I haven't pulled the package apart quite yet. And then this has a flange all the way around. They put the corner protector on already. They've done a great job of packaging these. And let's take for a quick look at the stats over here. Now, I did a full YouTube video on why you might want to choose double versus triple, but here's the short version of it. Here's the stats. The U factor on this window is 0.18. Remember, this is inverse of R factor. So if you take 1 divided by 0.18 on your phone, you're gonna find that's an R5.5. So these are almost, but not quite, twice as efficient when it comes to resisting heat flow as a double glaze window. These double glaze are 0.29 is the U factor, which translates to about R3.2 or so, somewhere in there. And they have a pretty similar solar heat gain coefficient. This double glaze is 0.19. My triple glaze over here is 0.23. I think U factor is really important because the resistance to heat flow is going to work for you 24/7, whether the sun's shining or not. And so I've opted for about a third of my windows in the house, somewhere around there, maybe almost half, to be triple glazed. The rest are double glazed. I also varied on where I put those. My north and eastern facing elevations in the house, those are where I'm using more triple glaze windows. My southern and western facing windows, I want that really low solar heat gain coefficient. I went with a double glaze there. The other thing I did on this house, which I think is a great tip, is I went with fixed or picture windows as much as possible. We don't want air leaking through our windows. There's always going to be some amount of leakage. But if I can minimize that by using fixed, I'm going to. And then where I've gone operable, I've mainly done, or not mainly, I've only done casements in bedrooms where I need egress. And one or two other places I've gone awning style. Remember, awning is where they're hinged at the top. Casement is where they're hinged on the side. The reason why I like those is when you crank those down and get them close, that lever that you pull cranks the window tight and makes it even more airtight compared to a window that you pull the lock and you've got, let's say, a double or a single hung. That's where you've got a sash that slides up and down in a frame like a traditional old window. Those tend to be more air leaky because you've got these brush seals that are brushing up against, and they need to be movable, right? You don't want them so stiff you can't move them, but that means they're automatically gonna be a little bit air leaky when the wind's blowing. Anyways, I got a full video on that on my YouTube channel. Big thanks to you guys for subscribing over here on Build Show Network. This is the place where you're gonna see Jake Bruton, Wade Paquin, Steve Basic, and of course, Brent Hull up in Fort Worth. These are fantastic builders, and Steve's an amazing architect. They just have some awesome videos about performance, about style, about aesthetics. Really, really smart. Now, we also have some new contributors coming on in the short-term future, so stay tuned. But if you're not currently a subscriber to our newsletter, I'll put a link in the description below. Sign up for that. We send out a video and a newsletter every Friday, a new video from me that's just a short one that says, here's what's new in our network this week. This is what Steve's up to. Here's what Wade's up to. Here's what I'm doing. And that's a great way to know what's new, and then we'll have links to those so you can click through on there. Guys, thanks so much for joining us over here. Hit that subscribe button below. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Otherwise, we'll see you next time on The Build Show.